I said money, broads, foreign cards, against all odds, I just want to get my paper money.
A show at the beginning of each week of testimony, and then another show at the end of the week. So we were live on Friday, and we recapped the first week. Now we're here to start the second week, which began today. And it was a very busy day. The prosecution put in dozens and dozens of freeze frames of still photos into evidence, trying to establish that the five murder suspects on trial for killing Lisandro Jr. Guzman Feliz were indeed at the scene, on the sidewalk, on the street, outside the bodega, which is located on East 183rd Street and Bathgate Avenue in the Belmont section of the Bronx. So for much of the day, we were very busy in the courtroom keeping up with all the testimony from Detective Francis Orlando, who works with Bronx Homicide. Now, let me show you the latest thing first. When we left court today, a little bit after 4 o'clock, Junior's parents pretty much said they wanted to talk to the media. They were facing a pack of reporters and cameras. That's the shot that I got outside. There's a breezeway at the side of the Bronx County Hall of Justice. Junior's parents, Leandra Feliz and Lisandro Guzman, asked to speak to reporters. Normally, we don't really talk to them after testimony at trial. They're usually led away by court officers and detectives from the NYPD, but today they asked to speak to reporters. And part of it was because it was very compelling what they had to watch today. You know, I know, that they've seen over and over again those surveillance videos that show Junior being dragged from the bodega to his deadly fate on the sidewalk. It's very difficult for parents to have to watch something like that. Today, they watched freeze frames of the same episode. Basically, different moments trying to establish which suspect was where on the sidewalk. There was one point where allegedly it was Jose Muniz in a white tank top outside the door where Junior was dragged out, and you see Junior grabbing at the door jamb, trying to...
Lo que ya nosotros hemos visto todo, y algo bien doloroso para todo y para la familia y para todo. Esto ya, quiero ya que termine esto ya pronto.
¿Cuán difícil fue este día de madre para Leandra?
Bien mal también. Sabe, como madre al fin, es bien doloroso para ti también, para todo. Thank you.
It was very difficult for him, like reliving everything that they already seen in these videos, seeing it now in court. And I asked him how difficult for his wife was this past Mother's Day, and it was horrible.
This is my torture. This is so very difficult. That's why I don't want to see it. I put my head down. I don't want to look at the videos. I don't want to see it no more.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, Junior's mother was literally doubled over with emotion at one point when she was looking at some of those freeze frames of the scene where her son was attacked. And I would like to address one thing about freeze frames, alleging that he is the person in the white tank top who was walking down East 183rd Street on the way toward the bodega on Bathgate Avenue. So a still photo of this was put into evidence. And this is something we brought you last September when we had access to some of the Junior files. So the detective, Francis Orlando, was saying, you know, he was led to believe that Jose Muniz is the one that was wearing the tank top. And then his mugshot was also entered into evidence, and there was a photo array that was shown to the jury. The next suspect that was spoken about, you've heard a lot about him, Joe Nike Martinez Estrella, you know, it's alleged that he plunged the knife into Junior's neck at the end of the attack. Well, the prosecution is saying he's the guy that was wearing the red t-shirt and a red Chicago Bulls hat at the beginning of the encounter by the bodega, but they're saying that by the time Junior was stabbed, that he had a white shirt on, he had taken off the red shirt, and allegedly that's him running away on the sidewalk with the red hat on. But we're going to loop it one more time. You know, prosecution says he had a red shirt on first, but then a white shirt underneath that when the stabbing actually took place. All right, let me go on to the next suspect that they talked about, Manuel Rivera. Now, he was only 18 years old when this happened. They showed some footage of him on the scene with brown hair, allegedly. They're saying this shows him in a beauty salon the next night, June 21st, 2018, and they're saying that by the time he was arrested,